स्टूडेंट्स, अ वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग. सो हियर टुडे लेट्स डिस्कस सम ऑफ द एमसीक्यूज प्रॉब्लम बेस्ड ऑन इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक. सो एज इन योर टर्म वन एग्जामिनेशन दैट इज गोइंग टू ऑर्गेनाइज बाय सीबीएसई, सो दैट विल बी एमसीक्यूज वे मीन्स देयर विल बी एमसीक्यूज क्वेश्चंस ऑफ 35 मार्क्स एंड इन दैट एमसीक्यूज सम एमसीक्यूज वी विल हैव. Along with that one, MCQs based on assertion reasoning as well as MCQ based on case study will be. So later we will also discuss the case study problems and assertion reasoning problem. But today we are going to discuss some of the questions based on MCQs type questions. And this all these questions I have taken mostly. This is from the NEET from the old years exactly, because that can be included in your questions, as they are very old question. That time pattern can arise in your home examination. But basically my thought was that here these type of questions are very basic question and that are very important question related to your topics that you have studied. So let's discuss one by one all the questions here. The first question is given, that is, a particle of mass m and charge q is placed at rest in uniform electric field E, then released. The kinetic energy attained by the particle after moving a distance y is. So here it is given, we have a particle. Suppose this is our particle, this is of mass m, then this is a charge, sum of the charge q, and this particle is now placed at rest in some uniform electric field E that is present here. So this is given in your question, and now this particle is released. So here after releasing it, it will travel some of the distance, and this distance is given y to us. Then we have to find out after moving this distance y, what is the kinetic energy that is attained by the particle. So whenever particle is being at rest in electric field, then that time it will experience a force, and due to that force it started to move. It means that if it has to cover some of the distance, then it has to do some work done. So we can use that concept here. So as we know, the work done is given by force into displacement. So in this case it is given, it is just displacing y by the force F. And also we know that whenever we have a charge q that is held in electric field E, so that will experience a force that is equal to Q into E. So our answer of the work done, that will be equal to QE by. So this is the work done that is used for the particles to travel distance y to attain the kinetic energy. So this work done is equal to kinetic energy here. So it means that our option B is correct now. So this is very basic question, that is nearly question of energy. So that we have studied already in class 11. So we have used that concept in the electrostatic portion. Now next one, let's see. So our second question is, now there is an electric field capital E in x direction. So if the work done in moving a charge 0.2 coulomb through a distance of 2 meter along a line making an angle 60 degree with x axis is now 4 joule. So the value of E is, so this is just like the same question that we have taken, only the difference is here it is given if electric field is along x axis. If this is our x axis, then electric field is along this axis, and now we have an axis that is inclined 60 degree here. So if any charge we have, that is 0.2 coulomb charge, that is moving the 2 meter here. Suppose from here this is point O we have, and from here point O to this point is B we have. So to on moving from O to B, it is covering a distance of 2 meter. So suppose distance I am writing by D, this is a given 2 meter, and this will be the distance that is equal to OB. So here it is given, if it is just moving at this inclined plane, the distance 2 meter and it the work done in whole of the situation is 4 joule, then we have to find the E. So as you can see now, E is in the direction of x axis. Then if we have to find out the work done in moving the particle or charge from O to B, then first we have to find out the component of either you can take the component of electric field in that direction, or you can take the component of displacement in that direction. So that will be equal to d cos theta in the direction of E. So work done, overall work done, this will, as it is F into D. So here in this case it will be F D cos of theta, and this theta is, now we have, this is given 60 degree. Clear, I think. And now as we know, F is equal to Q into E, and here this is now our D, and cos theta it has value 1/2. So F, I think that is now again clear. We have used in the previous question already, whenever some of the charge Q is placed in electric field E, then it experiences a force Q into E, and it is making some displacement D on this inclined plane, and the angle of inclination we have taken into consideration. So this will be properly F D cos theta, and we can write down now Q E D cos theta, that is 1/2. So let's solve it now. So if you will solve it, then finally we will get work done, and it is given 4 joule. So here as work done is given 4 joule, then this is 4 joule, that is equal to now QE. So Q is value 0.2 by according to our question. E is given that we have to find into D, that is 2, into cos theta, cos 60, that is 1/2. So these two will be cancelled out. And from here you can calculate the value of E. So this will be equal to 4/0.2, and this is equal to 20 Newton per coulomb. But here in our question, if you will see the options, then first option is 2√3, second is 5, third is 4, and fourth one is none of these. So as our answer is 20 Newton per coulomb, then it means that our correct option is none of these. So I think this question is also now clear. Let's see now this third question. Here the next question we have, this is theoretical question. The study of the effect associated with electric field at rest is known as what? So here as we know, number of fields in electromagnetism we have discussed, means whenever our charge is stationary, charge started to move, when our magnet is stationary and magnet started to move, then which kind of branch we are obtaining. So first branch that we are obtaining whenever charge is at rest, that is static branch. Means something is at rest, it means that static branch. Means next one, we are talking for the charge, means that is producing electric field. So it means that electrostatic, about that we are talking. So this is our first option is correct. Electrostatic is the study of the effect associated with electric field at rest. Now let's see the next one. Here the next question we have, when we touch the terminal of a high voltage capacitor, even after a high voltage has been cut off, then the capacitor has the tendency to. So here we are seeing a number of answers are given to us, and this is again some of the theoretical questions related to capacitor, but it is also related to the actually potential. Whenever we are touching a high terminal high voltage capacitor, means the capacitor is charged by the high voltage, and as you know that C is equal to or Q is equal to C into V, exactly you have the formula. So it means that whenever the voltage is increased, then according to increase in voltage for a particular value of capacitance, Q will be automatically increased. Means charge stored by the capacitor will increase due to high terminal potential here. So whenever you will just cut off even high potential, high voltage source after charging the capacitor, then charge is stored in the capacitor, and when we are touching it, charge started to discharge. So your first answer is we have, that is it started to discharge energy, and due to the discharging property, इट अफेक्ट अस डेंजरसली, मीन्स इफ यू विल टच इट चार्ज स्टार्टेड टू डिस्चार्ज थ्रू अवर बॉडी एंड मीन्स चार्ज स्टार्टेड टू फ्लो इन अवर बॉडी. कैपेसिटर स्टार्टेड टू डिस्चार्ज एनर्जी बट अवर बॉडी अफेक्ट डेंजरसली ड्यू टू दिस होल इफेक्ट. इट मीन्स दैट अवर ए एंड बी बोथ ऑप्शंस आर नॉट करेक्ट. इट डोंट रीस्टोर एनर्जी. सो यर लास्ट ऑप्शन इफ यू विल सी बोथ ए एंड बी. सो दिस ऑप्शन इज करेक्ट फॉर अस नाउ. फाइनली एक्चुअली दिस ऑप्शन आई हैव टोल्ड यू ओनली टू मेक यू अंडरस्टैंड. सो दिस इज द नॉट अलोन ऑप्शन. बोथ ऑफ द ऑप्शन आर करेक्ट. ड्यू टू द डिस्चार्जिंग ऑफ कैपेसिटर वी आर अफेक्टिंग डेंजरसली हियर. सो दैट्स वाई डी ऑप्शन इज नॉट करेक्ट. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन हियर. अ चार्ज क्यू माइक्रोकुलम इज प्लेस्ड एट द सेंटर ऑफ अ क्यूब. द फ्लक्स कमिंग आउट फ्रॉम एनी सरफेस विल बी. सो एज वी नो दैट इफ यू विल सी नाउ इफ दिस इज नाउ अवर क्यूब. सो इन एनी ऑफ द क्यूब एज वी हैव सिक्स फेसेस टोटल सिक्स फेसेस. Now you can see this cube has the six faces. So I think that is not very good cube, but still you can understand in cube there are six faces, and we know that the flux emerges from any of the face that is equal to q by epsilon zero. So this is the value of flux according to the concept of Gauss concept. If you will use the flux immerse out any surface is equal to 1 by epsilon 0 times charge enclosed by this one surface. So here it means that if a whole of the cube is enclosing a charge q microcoulomb, that is given, it is at center of the cube, it is enclosing that charge, then we will have the value here in this case, that is q. And if you will write down the q in a microcoulomb in a standard unit, so this will be q into 10 to the power minus 6 now. So it means that don't be confused by this factor. Here it is given that what is the flux coming out from any one surface. So as cube has six surface, then this the flux that you are seeing, that is through the whole six surfaces. So from only one surface, if you will see, this should be 1 by 6 times the whole of the flux. It means that its answer should be q into 10 to the power minus 6 upon 6 epsilon 0. So it means that if you will see now what is the option that is correct here. So this is the answer of our question, that is q into 10 power minus 6 upon 6 epsilon 0. This is the flux coming out of any one surface. Clear, I think. Now let's see the next question. Next question we have: the electric field required to keep a water drop of mass m just to remain suspended when charged with one electron is. Suppose we have a water drop here that is suspended, and this water drop is charged by one electron. It means that the charge on this one is equal to E, that E is charge of one electron, and its mass is given, this mass is now m. So you know that whenever any massive body that is suspended, then gravity will play a role here. So due to the gravity, its mass will weight will act in downward direction mc, and if we have to just balance it by electric field, that is given in our question, if we have to keep this water drop as suspended, then it means the force acting on this water drop in opposite direction to its weight, and that should be balanced. So that force, if you will see, this is the force, electric force, that is going to balance this force mz. So this is according to our question, what electric field we need here to keep the water drop to be suspended. So as you know, whenever you have any of the charge that is kept in some electric field, so this is given by E into E, the force, electrostatic force, that is E into E, and this is now equal to mz. So let's just solve here and let's find out the value of E. So if you will find out the value of E, then finally value of E will be equal to mz upon small e. So if you will see in our option where it is, so this is our option number B, that is correct. This is the electric field that is required to keep the water drop as suspended. So again, this is the use of the free body diagram that we are using. Now next one, the formation of dipole is due to two equal and dissimilar point charges placed at a. So here next one, this is very basic question. How can we form the dipole? So to form the dipole, first we need two of the charges. So this is suppose Q1 charge we have, this is Q2 charge we have. So we have to keep these Q1 and Q2 close each other, means at short distance, so that they can interact each other, they can bind each other. As the opposite charges we are keeping to produce or to just you can say that for the attraction of these one, and it is given in our question, we are keeping Q1 is equal to Q2, means magnitude of both charges are equal, but their polarity is opposite, means if one charge is of positive polarity, then other one will be of negative polarity automatically. So it means that in this whole cases, these two charges should be kept at small distance, so that they can attract the each other properly, they can bind each other, and a strong dipole can be formed. So our first option is correct here, that should be kept at the short distance to for the formation of dipole. Now next one, let's see. Next question is again related to the cube that we have seen. This is a charge Q is placed at the corner of the cube. In that case, actually it was at the center of the cube. It is now given a charge Q is placed at the corner of a cube. The electric flux through all the six faces of the cube is. So in this case, as if you will find out the charge Q that is placed at the corner, it is little different actually. Suppose this is again our cube, let me just first construct it. This is now our cube, and these are the now whole six faces, and it is our charge is at one of the corner of the cube, that you can see now our charge is located at one corner. So next one thing here, we have to calculate the electric flux through all six faces. Now one thing you have to understand, in this case this charge will be only enclosed by the three faces of the cube, not other three opposite faces. Like if you will see this one face, if you will see this one face, if you will see this downward face, in these all three faces are not going to cover this or enclose this charge, then that's why the flux emerges due to all these three faces, the tick three faces, that will be zero. So here only three faces that is going to contain this one and this one faces that is going to contain flux will emerge only due to this one. So according to Gauss law, if we will use to calculate the flux, then that flux should be equal to any one of the face, if you will see now. So according to this one, this should be equal to 1 by 3 times Q by epsilon 0 here. So it means that here in this case, if answer you will see, this answer should be this one, because only three faces are going to just connect the this one, you can say that the flux. Now next problem, if you will see, the next one is an electric dipole of moment P is lying along a uniform electric field capital E. So the work done in rotating the dipole by 90 degrees, so here as you know that the work done that is going to rotate it, that is equal to the torque exactly. So it means that so in this case the work done, that is you know given by in the case of dipole, that is equal to PE 1 minus cos of theta. So here theta is given, that is 90 degrees, so whenever you will put cos theta, that is cos 90, so this factor will be equal to 0, only this one factor we will obtain, so that is equal to simply PE. So it means that the third option C is correct here. This is the work done in rotating the dipole by 90 degrees. Now next question, the next question is the mean free path of electrons in metal is 4 × 10⁻⁸ meter. The electric field which can give on an average 2 electron volt energy
to an electron in the metal will be in units of volt per meter. So here this question is very actually simple. It is given the mean free path of the electrons, and you know what is the mean free path. This is the average distance traveled between any two consecutive collisions of particles. Means whenever you have two particles, suppose these are two particles, the distance traveled between these two particles are known as free path. And such kind of all particles, if you will take free path and its average, that is called mean free path. So suppose the average distance traveled between two electrons, that is given to us, this is equal to 4 × 10⁻⁸. Then we have to just find out the value of electric field which can give on the energy to electron volt here. So it means now the question is now very actually simple, and this is quite easy. So here as electric field, you know this is equal to V/d. We can use this formula directly. So as 2 electron volt, it means that potential is given to us and distance is given. So potential is, we have 2 electron volt already, and 2 upon if you will write down the mean free path, so this mean free path will have the value 4 × 10⁻⁸. So directly if you will solve it, then its value is obtained to as 0.5 × 10⁸, or if you will just again solve this one, so this is equal to 5 × 10⁷ volt per meter. So according to our question, the C option is correct for this one. Now next question is, from a point charge, there is a fixed point A. At A, there is an electric field of 500 volt per meter, potential difference of 3000 volt. So distance between the point charge and A will be. So here in this case, a point charge, suppose this is a point charge that is given, and there is a fixed point A is given. Suppose this is our point A. Okay? So it is given that at A, there is an electric field. At this point, electric field E is given to us, and as well as potential difference V is given. Then it is asked, what is the suppose if O is our point from where A point we are taking into observation, so we have to find out the distance between point charge and A. It means that we have to find OA. So we can use the relationship between electric field and potential here to find out the distance between these two particles. So the as you know, the electric field and potential are related by the formula E is equal to V/d. So we have to find out D here. So D will have the value V upon E. So let's write down now values. So according to this one, this value of D will be equal to V/E. Means V is, we have this is 3000, and E we have this is 500 volt per meter. So these two zeros will be cancelled out, and if you will solve, then this will be equal to 6 meter. So this is our answer of the question. The distance between point charge and A is 6 meter. Now next question, this is, if a dipole moment P is placed in uniform electric field E, then the torque acting on it is given by. So this is the direct formula it is asked in our question. So as you know that the torque is the cross product of, vector cross product of dipole moment and electric field. So this is, this value is directly correct. This is P cross E. So here I think there is no need to discuss it more. The next question, let's see. Here, the electric intensity due to a dipole of length 10 cm and having a charge of 500 microcoulomb at a point on the axis of the distance, axis at a distance 20 cm from one of the charge in air is. So again, this is the question related to the dipole and also the value of the electric field at axial point. Like if this is our dipole, suppose, and two charges we have, this is Q charge, this is Q charge, they are separated by some of the distance, suppose here 2A, then if at axial point, means on the axis of this one, if some of the point is situating and the distance of that point is given, suppose this is R, then electric field at this point P is given by, due to dipole, by the formula, that is K 2P R upon R square minus of A square होल स्क्वायर. सो वी कैन यूटिलाइज दिस फॉर्मूला हियर टू कैलकुलेट इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड. सो लेट्स यूज द फॉर्मूला डायरेक्टली हियर. सो वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड. सो ई विल बी इक्वल टू के. इट मीन्स दैट 9 इंटू 10 टू द पावर 9, बिकॉज इट इज गिवेन, इट इज इन एयर. सो द इन एयर द वैल्यू ऑफ परमिटिविटी इज एप्सिलॉन 0. सो वी कैन यूज इट डायरेक्टली. नाउ नेक्स्ट वन वी हैव टू राइट डाउन 2. वी हैव टू राइट डाउन द वैल्यू ऑफ पी, दैट इज डायपोल मोमेंट. एंड डायपोल मोमेंट इज इक्वल टू क्यू इंटू 2a, मीन्स वन ऑफ द चार्ज. दिस इज 500 माइक्रो कूलॉम. सो वी कैन कन्वर्ट इट इंटू कूलॉम नाउ इंटू हियर. नेक्स्ट वन 2a मीन्स द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द डायपोल्स डायपोल चार्जेस, एंड दैट इज गिवेन अकॉर्डिंग टू डायपोल लेंथ. इट इज गिवेन 10 सेंटीमीटर. सो वी कैन कन्वर्ट इंटू इन मीटर बाई मल्टीप्लाइंग 10^-2. अगेन नेक्स्ट वन इंटू आर वी हैड इन इक्वेशन. सो आर इज गिवेन 20 सेंटीमीटर. सो दिस इज 20 × 10^-2. नाउ अपॉन होल ऑफ दिस अपॉन आर स्क्वायर माइनस ए स्क्वायर. सो आर स्क्वायर मीन्स 20 होल स्क्वायर माइनस ऑफ ए स्क्वायर मीन्स हियर ए दैट विल बी 5, बिकॉज 2a इज गिवन 10 सेंटीमीटर. ए विल बी 5 होल स्क्वायर दिस वन. एंड ऑल्सो एज दिस ऑल इन सेंटीमीटर यू विल कन्वर्ट इन टू मीटर. सो दिस विल बी 10^-8 फाइनली. नाउ दिस इज होल द हियर मल्टीप्लीकेशन एंड डिवीजन यू आर सीइंग. यू हैव टू जस्ट सॉल्व इट एंड आफ्टर सोल्यूशन यू कैन फाइंड आउट द वैल्यू ऑफ द क्वेश्चन एंड वैल्यू ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड एट एक्सियल पॉइंट. सो दैट आंसर विल बी करेक्ट फॉर दैट वन. सो डायरेक्टली लेट्स जस्ट कैलकुलेट इट एंड यू कैन फाइंड आउट दिस आंसर. सो हियर द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन स्टूडेंट यू विल सी दैट इज अ हॉलो इंसुलेटेड कंडक्शन स्फीयर इज गिवेन अ पॉजिटिव चार्ज 10 microcoulomb. सो वॉट विल बी द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड एट सेंटर ऑफ द स्फीयर इफ इट्स रेडियस इज 2 meters. सो इन दिस क्वेश्चन हियर इट इज वेरी एक्चुअली सिंपल क्वेश्चन. क्वेश्चन वी हैव अ हॉलो इंसुलेटेड कंडक्शन स्फीयर. सो दिस इज अ हॉलो इंसुलेटेड इंडक्शन स्फीयर एंड दैट इज गिवेन अ पॉजिटिव चार्ज 10 microcoulomb. सो यू नो दैट वेन एवर यू हैव द हॉलो स्फीयर एंड दैट्स ऑल ऑफ द पॉजिटिव चार्जेस विल जस्ट दिस इफ दिस इज कंडक्टर देन इट्स ऑल चार्जेस विल रिसाइड ऑन द सरफेस हियर. इन दिस वे ऑल चार्जेस विल रिसाइड हियर. सो इट मीन्स दैट इनसाइड द सरफेस नो चार्ज विल बी देयर. सो इनसाइड द सरफेस एज चार्ज इज नाउ 0 ड्यू टू इट्स कंडक्टिंग प्रॉपर्टीज. देन इफ यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड एट द सेंटर देन ऑब्वियसली एज नो चार्ज इज कंटेन्ड इनसाइड द सेंटर नो इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड विल बी देयर मीन्स 0 इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड विल बी देयर. सो दिस इज वेरी क्वाइट ईजी प्रॉब्लम एंड दिस काइंड ऑफ प्रॉब्लम कैन बी आस्क्ड इन मेनी वेज. सपोज इट इज गिवेन टू यू दैट इज यू हैव अ हॉलो कंडक्टिंग क्यूब एंड अ चार्ज सम पॉजिटिव चार्ज और नेगेटिव चार्ज इज गिवेन टू दैट क्यूब देन वट विल बी द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड एट द सेंटर. Answer will be same for that one also. So it means that here in this case again answer is same for that one, because if your body is conducting body then its property of conductor all the charges will prefer to reside on the surface. No of the charges present inside the surface if you have made some of the hollow cavity there. So in that hollow cavity always no charge is present inside, then that means electric field is 0 there. So directly you have to just tick the answer 0 for this kind of situation when you have hollow conducting body, means hollow cavity, that we are calling also Faraday case. So here the Faraday case application is given in our question. You have to utilize that. Question we have, this is intensity of an electric field E depends on distance R due to a dipole is related as. So as you know, if you will see the dipole, in which case if certain condition you will use when the value of R is much greater than value of A. So in much greater than condition, if you will see the electric field that is given by K 2P upon R cube. So it means that here if you will see the electric field is inversely proportional to R cube. This is, it means that our option 3 is now correct for this one case. Clear, I think. Now next question, let's see here. A
question we have, this is a charge q is enclosed by a Gaussian spherical surface of radius r. If the radius is doubled, then the outward electric flux will be. So here it is given that we have an Gaussian surface. Suppose this is of a spherical shape and it is enclosing a charge q. Then we have to just first of all calculate flux by this one. So you know flux by using Gauss theorem, if you will use, that is equal to charge enclosed by the surface to the epsilon zero, that is permittivity of free space. So here as it is given, we are just increasing the radius, but not we are disturbing the charge that is enclosed by the surface. So we know that the flux from any surface is not depending on the size of the size of the surface or size of the Gaussian surface. So it is depending on the charge enclosed by that surface and permittivity, medium in which our surface is placed. So as medium is not changing, charge enclosed is not changing, then there should not be any change in the this whole of the flux. It means that it will remain the same. So C option is correct for this one question. So students, number of MCQs we have discussed on electrostatics, all the I think topics we have covered in this electrostatic portion. So this is I think now easy to understand which kind of MCQs can be asked in your examination, what you have to prepare, some theoretical questions, some numerical questions, conceptual question, all can be here. So just focus on this one, and now let's our end our class here for this case. We will discuss the rest of the things in next class. So thank you students for